So women are often concerned about their fertility when they have to choose a contraceptive method. You know, sometimes when some women experience delay trying to conceive, they go back and start thinking, could it be the birth control I used at some point? So does hormonal birth control affect infertility? What are the chances? Is it true? Yes or no? Well, it's Stephanie Young, the health teacher, here again, and I'll be giving you the facts as always. So generally, birth control are often broadly classified into two categories. So you have hormonal birth control and non-hormonal birth control methods. Simply put, birth control, contraception, it means preventing pregnancy. So non-hormonal birth control methods do not use synthetic hormones in preventing pregnancy, while the hormonal birth control uses synthetic hormones in preventing pregnancy. So how does it work, right? So hormonal birth control methods would work either of three ways. One, prevent ovulation from happening. So if there's no egg, there'll be nothing for the sperm to fertilize, right? That's the first way it works. The second way is it thickens the cervical mucus, so it's inconducive for a healthy sperm to swim through. And the third is it thins the endometrial lining, so a fertilized egg is unable to implant. So from the beginning of your menstrual cycle, the lining of your endometrial wall, your endometrial lining, continues to build up, you know, to be thick enough for a fertilized egg to implant when pregnancy occurs. So from the beginning of the cycle, every cycle a woman has, your body prepares for a possible pregnancy, whether or not you're interested. So it is at the end, when fertilization doesn't occur, there's no pregnancy, those the ticking wall that has built up from the beginning of the cycle then sheds as period. So it disintegrates and then comes out as period. So that's what you see as a period. So the third way it works is that it thins the endometrial lining. There's nothing, no support for a fertilized egg. So even if fertilization occurs, the pregnancy will not happen because it cannot implant. You understand that, right? So that's how it works. Three ways. So does hormonal birth control cause infertility?
No, it doesn't, but here are four important facts you should know.
So the first is time for return to fertility. So with different hormonal birth control methods, return to fertility can vary. So for most of them, you have return to fertility taking about 1 to 3 months. Now, return to fertility simply means when your normal cycle, you know, when it comes back, when you go back to having your normal menstrual cycle. So it can take anywhere from 1 to 3 months. Some women may experience temporary delays, but it will definitely come back. For the injection shot, it can take anywhere from 6 to 12 months, or sometimes even as long as 22 months in some women, which is almost 2 years, right? So if you want to have children in the near future, these are the factors you should be considering. Return to fertility is a very important factor in determining the type of birth control method you go for. Number two is it can mask cycle irregularities, right? So because some of these methods work in such a way that you bleed from time to time, it feels like you're seeing your period, though it's not a menstrual period, though, because a true menstrual period is one that follows ovulation. So that would be breakthrough bleeding. So from time to time you bleed and you just feel like everything is okay. So it masks irregularities, like, you know, when a woman has a cycle that is longer than normal or shorter than normal, irregular bleedings, or there's an underlying factor that causes a woman not to ovulate. So you have anovulatory cycles in which you do not ovulate. Because your body has been programmed to have breakthrough bleeding, because you're using this method, you know, you do not know you have this irregularity. So the minute you go off birth control, you begin to see these irregularities and it looks like the birth control caused it. No, it didn't cause it. It has been there all the while, but the birth control method you use has masked the symptoms and you cannot see them on time. The third is untreated sexually transmitted infections. So many times they tell you when you use a hormonal birth control, it will not prevent the transmission of, you know, sexually transmitted infections. But how many women go on to use a barrier method in addition to it? So you're supposed to use a barrier method in addition to a hormonal birth control method to be able to prevent sexually transmitted infections. So many people just assume this is supposed to protect them from sexually transmitted infections, or, you know, they don't just like the idea of whatever the case may be, right? There can be transmission of sexually transmitted infections, and if a woman has this infection for a very long time left untreated, it can cause infertility in the future. And the last point, which is the time a woman goes off birth control. So generally, you know, it is said that fertility declines with age in women, basically in their 30s, or specifically by the age of 35. So the time you go off birth control matters. So for a woman who would go off birth control in her late 20s or by 30, will definitely have a higher chance of achieving pregnancy than a woman who goes off birth control at the age of 35 or in her late 30s. So the time a woman goes off birth control matters. So these are the four reasons why it may seem like hormonal birth control causes infertility. No, it doesn't cause infertility directly, but these are factors you want to consider when you want to make the choice of a contraceptive method. So it's advised that if at the age of 35, you know, if you're 35 and below and you've been trying to conceive for about a year without success, you should see your healthcare provider. While if you're above the age of 35, you've been trying for 6 months without success, please go and see your healthcare provider. But I like to say you don't have to wait that long. If you feel something is wrong or there might be a problem, the earlier you go and get it sorted, know what the problem is and the solutions available, the better. You don't have to wait that long. So that's it. Check the link in the bio or below this video for resources that can help you either with preventing pregnancies or achieving pregnancy, the different methods available, including natural methods of contraception and fertility awareness. You know, go there and check it. There are a lot of resources you can use. And don't forget to drop in your questions. Cheers. Bye.